Now there's something about using the right float. You know, it's called almost like a pencil float. It's balsa wood, but I mean, almost no resistance whatsoever. When the fish are aggressive and they pop the float, knock the float, and it goes all over the place, that's one thing. But when you get a light bite with a small jig, like the Popeye jig, on the float, you want something that's streamlined, so they just knock it and it just goes right down. They feel nothing. They hold on to that jig and help you catch fish. So I get their tension, put it in, a few little knocks. Again, all about finding them on a tree. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh yeah, look at this. Dudes. A waker. See, what's a waker? Well, it's waking me up and it's making a wake all the way to the boat. You have to twitch it a few times. Wake him up. And then when he's seeing the Popeye jig, easy boy. What's wrong with you, man? You got bad attitude. Look how he ate it again. Hey, look at that little jig. Right up through the top. There's no way, no way that that fish is coming off. Unless he got stuck on brush, which he did a little bit. But just another good eater, huh? Man, oh man. I love bobber fishing. He's just an eater. We got some real big guys. Take some pictures and stuff. But I mean, for eating, how can you beat it? Love it. And how can you not use a little hair jig like the Popeye? Sharp little hook tied directly to my line. And I put a little split shot on there too, because I want my float to sit totally vertical. Remember, that's only 1/16 ounce, okay? So it takes quite a bit to get the float. Otherwise, the float sits like this. A lot of times when the float's in the water like that, it'll lay down from fish that eats it. So I want that tension of the small split shot to be totally vertical. So my bobber is where it should be. Oh, wow. I tell you, man, when those fish are deep, like we're sitting in 3.9, okay? And I got my blades in about 7 feet of water. But with a tree like this, you can see the angle that's sticking up the trees, the branches, right? So it's going down like that. And I've only got my float set with the stopper about 18 inches, maybe 20 inches. So you know they're sitting in those trees, just like you see the paintings and pictures of crappie all sitting in there. It lands that little Popeye jig, little hair, by me twitching the thing, just subtle, just little twitch. Twitch, let it sit. It's violent. You see how the float goes whoa, like right down. They're not coming up and just like taking it and going. They're like racing the other crappie to it. So you position the boat with the power poles, stay back, see where the trees are angling down, and then put your casts right where you think they could be sitting on the tree, sort of like this. Let's see. Right about there. Is there one there? Yep. Oh my goodness. Wow. Isn't that wild? Isn't that wild? Crappies, I love you, man. I love you. Because sometimes when you figure it out, and trust me, there's days, man, I go out like anybody, boy, and it's like pulling teeth, wisdom teeth, to get bit. But on days when you can catch decent crappies, that's maybe 11 inch, you're lucky you're not big enough, you got a small mouth. I'll let you go. But when you can catch them, and have fun, embrace it, enjoy the moment. Don't think about the next one right away. Have fun, man, you know, really. Because crappie fishing is what it's all about. And these little fine wire hooks, see how it's bent like that? I just take my pliers and just open it up just a bit like that, just to get that top of the mouth in that meat of the crappie. And that will increase your hook sets to hooking the meat or getting the metal to meet the meat. Big time, right there, just by slowly opening up. Because you're catching fish, you're taking the hook out, you're betting and stuff like that. If you're not paying attention to the little things, you're just gonna get heartbroken. So let's put it in one more time. Let's see if we can get a fish right here, right on the same segment, right there. Lands. Come on, get mad at it. Get mad. Wow, did you see that, dude? And he got stuck. Holy God, dude. He came up and he ate it. He got stuck. He stuck on the tree. Do you believe that? That was unreal, man. He came up. He there he goes. I got him. You let off and he comes off. He came out of the water, not a giant fish, but he raced his buddies to eat the Popeye jig. You saw it live right here on our show, man. out of the water like a crazy little bugger, aren't you? I'm gonna put you in there because you're a good one. Wow, I'll probably let you go. But just, I don't want you to go back to that tree and spook your little friends. Unreal, man. Blow! Boom! You get stuck on the tree like a largemouth. My heartbeat, wow. That's healthy, you know, seriously. Catching crappie is healthy for you because it gets the blood flow. Wow. Oof. See how important it is sometimes to do exactly what the fish want? I had the bobber too deep. You know, I wanted to fish the edges of the tree when I first showed up and I got a couple fish, but I still had it deep. Then when I got closer, put the power poles down, those fish I could see, they're actually hitting the bottom of the float and the split shot and missing the Popeye jig whatsoever. I shortened it up and catch way more fish and bigger fish. Look what the fish are doing with where they are in the water column, because sometimes they're totally opposite where you think they are in the trees, and they're right up high.